Probably have to do a submission for the waifu. The battle is over, but Maria's whereabouts remain unknown. Which is probably what disappoints me most. I was really hoping to have a rematch with her in this DLC, but I guess they're saving that for the next one. So let's see, do I have any new submissions unlocked? There's this one here taking place in the same stage. Probably not going to be too interesting that. What about this one? Ganryu. Sounds like it might be a duel. I'm curious who would be challenging me, so I think I'll try this one out. But before I forget, yeah, let's check out the how many times I've died to some of the tougher bosses. Character directory? No, that's not it. Where is it? Tail the Neo? No. Thought Emitter? Under character directory, are you sure? Oh, right, of course there's not going to be a death count for Hanzo. I haven't fought him yet. Actually, wait, no, I have fought him, so there should be one. Where is it? Change information. There it is, okay. Let's actually just have a look at everyone. So I've died 3 times to Hanzo, 6 times to Okatsu. This must only count their story boss fights then, because I'm sure I've died more times to them in the various submission refights that they scatter. So it's not quite accurate. Munishige has killed me 18 times. Wow, that's a surprisingly high amount. That must have been from when I farmed him. I tend to end up getting rather lazy when I farm enemies and end up having a bunch of dumb deaths. I seriously only died once to Magoichi, really? Yeah, pretty much the only thing you really need to understand about this game is it's Samurai Dark Souls, or Ninja Gaiden meets Dark Souls. Wait a minute, what? Okay, these numbers don't make any sense. Because I've beaten Sakon and Yoshitsugu before. Why does it say 0? I'm confused. Yeah, it must only count certain instances in the story then, because I've definitely fought these people in various submissions. So yeah, not the most accurate. 9 times to Nobunaga. Once to Derek the Executioner, my eternal shame that. Thrice to Kelly. I guess I don't actually have stats for Mr. D. Where's the DLC stuff? Nagayoshi, yep, he is all like the super bosses that the game has pretty much. Here's the DLC stuff. So, 11 times to Masamune. Really? I only died 11 times? That doesn't seem right. Yeah, this clearly is not accurate information. I made way more than 11 attempts. That's unfortunate. 25 times to Shigazani, which that seems more accurate. This guy does a stupidly high amount of damage. 30 times to Lady Maria. Yep, that seems pretty accurate as well. It's funny, the game just refers to her as Maria, but the Bloodborne parallels just seem so strong to me that I just end up unconsciously adding Lady in front of her name every time I refer to her. Yes, this number seems accurate. 3 deaths to Sanada, Yukimura. And 5 to Sasuke, the anime edgelord. Alright, well, it was a fun little diversion. Let's see what this submission's about. Yeah, a lot of Dates. They really should just call this a Date simulator. It's more accurate. Alright, who am I gonna fight? Let me just get my buffs up. Oh, it's... okay. This is interesting. This looks to be the third boss fight I was looking for. Okay! Hi. I wonder who this is supposed to be. It's assuredly some historical figure. This isn't, what's his name? Musashi, is it? Because this has to be some sort of big, important figure, and I do remember Musashi, someone saying somewhere that they were related to one of the DLCs, or would likely be, just because of what they did in actual history. Good lord. This might take a while. Musashi's a dual wielder? Okay. I think my mind went to him just because he's a big name and the whole him fighting with a boat oar, which is a big weapon, and the Odachi that this dude is wielding is a big weapon, but yeah, otherwise I don't think there's too much of a similarity. Alright, well he starts off slowly, so that actually gives me a chance to be a lame ass. I wonder if I can cheese him with the kunai. No such luck. Okay! This guy's making full use of the Odachi moveset, that's for sure. Well, he actually doesn't have all that much health. Oh, I tried to go for the parry. Didn't work out. This guy is badass. Oh, Musashi showed up in one of the submissions in the base game? I don't remember that. Maybe I didn't do that one. If I can get a single parry here, I think I actually might be able to take off a ridiculous chunk of this guy's health. Because he doesn't seem all that tanky. Not that he needs to be tanky, holy shit. Okay, I keep trying to get around behind him when I'm not going for my parry attempt, so maybe I should try and just stay in front of him. Gotta figure out what works here. I'm kind of already giving up on my parry game because it doesn't seem to be working too well for me. And yeah, my regular attacks do a surprisingly large amount of damage. These dual-type bosses usually end up being tankier, even if they're more agile sorts. But this guy actually has a reasonable amount of health and defense for his fighting style. Seems like the developers actually listen to reason here. He's just so dangerous because of how ridiculously quick and efficient he is with that Odachi moveset. I'm dead. Kind of a shame he doesn't seem to have any special grab animations, or at least he hasn't gone for them. Those are always the most fun ways to be killed by humanoid opponents. They tend to have unique ones. Yeah, I tried to go for the parry there. Didn't work out too well for me. He is actually somewhat slow to approach, so I might be able to get my one-up back. I wonder, if I can get behind him, can I then stunlock him with kunai? That might work. Oh no. Okay, I'm glad he started putting up his guard up again. If I was able to just cheese him like some other humanoid opponents with kunai spam, I would have been very disappointed. You know what, it's been a while since I've used the new weapon, the Tonfus. It's gonna get me killed, but I want to do it anyway. And honestly, the fact that they do end up doing a lot of key damage might help me here. Oh, get away. He was the one that got away. Oddly enough, it seems that just running around to one side is actually a pretty effective method of avoiding a lot of his attacks. Case in point. I'm gonna switch to mid stance, because I think that's the stance I have that ridiculous combo that I can do. I think I have to do triangle after a number of square inputs. Forget. Oh, let me heal up to full. What if it turned out that this guy had elixirs too and he started popping them off when he got to lower HP? I don't think I've ever encountered a humanoid enemy that's not a play of Evident that's done that. That would certainly be an interesting way of shaking things up here. I'm trying to get his key down, but I can't seem to do it. And there goes all my elixirs. I think this attempt might be a bust. Okay, he has dialogue. That means I've gotten him to low enough HP that he might be entering a phase 2. So far his moveset doesn't seem any different though. If I had a choice of what weapon type the next DLC adds, I would really hope it would be a proper bare fist sort of weapon. You can kind of make bare fists work if you get all the bonuses and you end up doing a lot of damage, but it doesn't actually have a proper moveset, which is super disappointing in a game like this. Like, come on, it's set in like Sengoku period Japan. You'd kind of expect there to be some sort of martial arts. And a few characters do end up doing stuff like that, like Okatsu, but the player really can't. Alright, I'm gonna go back to parry practice. Just because I really want to do that. It's very efficient and it looks really cool when you can actually get the timing down. Really though, the game is telling me I shouldn't be going for that. Oh, that's not the elixirs. Whoops. Yeah, hell, even just a bare fist skill tree, that would actually work better, because then you wouldn't have to farm up weapons. I would probably end up switching over to bare fist, at least if I like the moveset, purely for that reason. Not having to play into this bullshit farming game. You know what, I'm gonna stick with the katana, but I'm actually just gonna use its moveset and not go for the parries. And see how that goes. Yeah, this guy definitely does seem like he's quicker than the player with the Odachi. Like that one 3-hit combo, it's definitely slower in the player's hands. I know that for a fact because that was a combo I really liked using when I used the Odachi. Not because it was especially effective, but just because of the pretty colors it makes. The red, the blue, and the green. Very aesthetically pleasing using that. Oh, I'm trying to dodge through his attacks, but he has such wide arcs. Kind of dodging into them. What if I could get his key down just by spamming kunai? Ah, I mean, it's technically working. Oh, this is the most ridiculous sight. There we go. Oh, damn it, I didn't throw that last one quick enough. Well, there goes all that effort. Barefist BA would also be pretty awesome, yes. You really don't get many chances to actually hit this guy. He puts up his guard so damn quickly. Which also means it's actually difficult to do key damage. Because the best key damage is from the kick, which you can only do after a successful regular sword swing. So maybe the Nunchaku... Tanfas. Would actually be better if I want to damage his key, since they just do a shit ton of key damage anyway. At least in high stance. Yeah, look at that shit. Most of his key bar gone. We time that just right. And don't actually give him space to recover. I might do this. Clearly he has other opinions on the matter though. Yep, definitely. The sword vault is when I can go in for the most damage, but even then, he still ends up recovering surprisingly quickly. There we go. Pretty good damage too. Damn, I got him in half. That's way better than anything I've done in any of my previous attempts. Ah, damn it. I was starting to have dreams that I might be able to do the Crusher, the no damage achievement, but of course not. Still though, I seem to have found my groove when fighting this dude, so unless he has any new tricks to whip out all of a sudden, I might have this. Nope, not an elixir. It helps that he's not doing the three-hit sparkly combo. Easily the most deadly of his moves. Oh no, come on. Thank God for that one-up. Okay, I do think he has a few new moves he's doing, mainly that dashing move. I gotta stop running away, that actually puts me in a worse position. Yeah, he's so good at getting away. And again, most humanoid opponents are. They gotta make breaking the key somewhat difficult. Otherwise, you'd never have to give any effort in these fights. I could actually probably be making use of my kunai when he tries to get away like that. That actually didn't work out so well. Yeah, it was not a good time. That was not a good time to use that item. Wow, okay. Damn, that was so close too. I didn't expect him to just pretty much one-shot me out of nowhere like that. That's what I get for not being at full health. honestly, by humanoid enemy standards in this game, this guy actually doesn't seem all that bad. I just gotta get better. And I don't actually have sloth talismans on this character, I think. I might have them unlocked, I'm not sure, but I don't like using them. They're too much of a crutch, because they prevent you from actually learning the enemy's moveset at their default speed. Which I just don't really like. Oh damn, didn't expect him to recover so quickly. Oh, might be able to break his key with kunai spam. Yeah. Kunai spam, OP. Yeah, this guy's done. Oh crap, unless I run out of kunai. There we go. I really should stop declaring my victory before I actually achieve it. That never seems to work out for me, funnily enough. And done. Aw, oh, come on, that would have been such a cool finisher. Come on, game. Instead, I had to blow him up, which is actually also surprisingly cool. Oh! Let's see, let's actually check out the armor I picked up. I might have picked up his set, assuming he has one. Which might actually tell me who the hell he is. It tells me nothing. Oh, this might be it. I'm just trying to look at like keywords to see if I recognize any of the names. But it doesn't look like it, unfortunately. The annoying thing about the armor is you can end up getting other characters' armor sets from a wide variety of characters. Actually, I suppose that's a good thing. It gives you multiple farming options. Okay, let's send this. Yeah, it was a fun fight. And a pretty good end to the DLC, I think. Even if this ends up unlocking another submission that's a dual one, I think I'll be ending things here. Honestly, I think I actually feel better after having done this DLC than I did the first one, even if it was overall lower in quality. Mainly because I didn't spend 2 hours fighting two bosses like I did with Masamune and Maria. Even though they were good bosses, I was just completely drained by that point. So yeah, that's the Defiant Honor Neo DLC, the second of three. I'm looking forward to the third, and hopefully it ends up being good. Oh, I think I might have actually said that. I think that was actually supposed to be Sasaki Kojiro, who is the the supposed person that is famous for dueling Masamune, though he may not have actually existed. He may have been a purely fictional person. So, not quite Musashi, but someone similar, someone related. And yeah, that's it for the DLC. Reveals this time. Thanks to anyone who watched, and hope you enjoyed.